Namaste and a very warm welcome to all. Myself, JVN Dr. Hemant Vyas, Associate Professor and Head of Department of Surgery, Faculty of Homeopathic Science, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. So students, today we are going to discuss about an important topic from ear, nose and throat, that is ENT. And the name of topic is Deviated Nasal Septum. So, as you know, our nose is made up of two parts, that is bony part as well as cartilaginous part. So, the which is the superior part is actually made up of bone, and these bones are nasal spine of the frontal bone. And it is continued caudally with the cartilage, and this cartilage is perpendicularly placed on the vomer bone. On the front side or caudal side, there is membranous part of this cartilage, which is not made up of cartilage or bone. So basically these three parts make the nose or nasal septum. Now, what are the reasons for deviation of this nasal septum? So friends, this is because of certain reasons. Most common reason for deviation of nasal septum is trauma. So there are various types of traumas, and they produce different type of injuries or different type of deviations inside the nose. So for example, if the trauma is because of blow from front, okay, so front side there is blow, then it causes buckling of the nasal septum. Or if the trauma is from the lateral side, it causes displacement of the nasal septum. Then there may be some other causes of trauma, like birth trauma, which is in old times when the births were conducted with the help of forceps deliveries, and nowadays forceps delivery is completely banned, and there is no such cases of trauma because of forceps injuries. But in older times, there was forceps deliveries, and because of that, sometimes the deviated nasal septum might have occurred because of these reasons. So these are the traumas which can cause deviation of the nasal septum. Then next common cause is the developmental cause. So our nasal cavity is laterally bound with the facial bones. So the bones are fixed at their place, but if the cartilage grows more rapidly than the growth of bone, at that time there is less space for accommodation of this cartilage, and at that time there is buckling, or at that time there is buckling of the nasal septum. So these are the common reasons for development of there are few more, like congenital, that is if the baby is placed in abnormal position inside the womb, then the baby may get born with the deviated nasal septum. Then it may be hereditary, that is deviation of nasal septum may run in hereditary sometimes. So these are the common reasons for development of deviated nasal septum. Now let's see what are the types of deviated nasal septum. So deviated nasal septum has four main types, that is anterior deviation, in which the nasal septum is anteriorly deviated, and next is C-shaped deviation, in which the nasal septum is deviated on either right side or left side curve. It has right or left side curve, which is called as C-shaped deviation. then it may be S shaped deviation, in which there is S shape, the deviation looks like the S letter of the alphabets. Then there is a calcaneal spur, that is a projection, means the septum is having some projections, a V shaped projection inside the cartilage or bony part, and this septum continuously irritate the turbinates or the mucous membrane, and it may cause bleeding also. So these are the common types of the deviated nasal septum. Now let's see what are the symptoms which are produced due to deviated nasal septum. So friends, deviated nasal septum is found very commonly in the population, and near about 80% population is affected due to deviated nasal septum. But every person who is having deviated nasal septum do not show the symptoms, and the symptoms are produced only in few cases. So near about 80% people are affected due to deviated nasal septum, but only few of them are affected or only few of them show symptoms. So let's see what are the symptoms of deviated nasal septum. First is recurrent rhinitis, that is recurrent infection of the nose. Whenever there is deviation in the upper part of the nose, that creates more obstruction for the flow of the air, and because of that there is obstruction to the air, and this causes difficulty in breathing, and the patient feels that nose is always obstructed, and because of this there is also recurrent infections inside the nose, and recurrent rhinitis. The patient may suffer with recurrent rhinitis. So next is headache. Headache is a very important symptom in the deviated nasal septum, and it may have different mechanisms for development of headache. So first is sinusitis headache, which is due to deviated nasal septum. So what happens in our face, there are different sinuses, like our maxillary sinus, which is placed in the cheeks, then our frontal sinus, and ethmoidal and sphenoidal sinus behind the nose, and these all sinuses drain inside the nasal cavity. But when the septum is deviated, it causes obstruction to the flow, to the opening of these sinuses. These sinuses open inside the nasal cavity, but due to deviated nasal septum, these openings may get blocked, and when these openings may get blocked, at that time there is saturation of mucus secretion. Like maxillary sinuses, they have mucus membrane or mucus lining inside them, so there are some secretions, and when these secretions cannot drain inside the nasal cavity, they get trapped, and because of stagnation, we all know there is infection. When the secretions get stagnated, there is secretion, there is infection inside that secretions, and the person suffers recurrently with sinusitis. That is, the person may have frontal sinusitis or maxillary sinusitis, and depending upon the sinus affected, there is the person has symptoms or the person has headache. Then there may be vacuum headache. The vacuum headache is because of the air which is present inside the sinuses. It gets sucked up, and because of this the person suffers from there is creation of vacuum, and that creates lots of pain inside the cheeks or head of that person. Or other reasons may be because of the constantly irritating spur. So we have also seen one type of deviated nasal septum is spur formation. So in cases of spur formation, there is constantly pricking sensation inside the nose, and which creates irritation and headache inside the in the patient. Then because of spur, there may be recurrent bleeding from the nose. So this is the common, these are the common symptoms which you can see in the deviated nasal septum. Now let's move forward. What are the complications of deviated nasal septum? It causes recurrent sinusitis, as we have discussed now. It causes nosebleed. It causes middle ear infections. It may cause asthma, or it may also cause atrophic rhinitis. So what is atrophic rhinitis? We are going to study it in deep in further lectures. So now we have to discuss about the treatment options of the deviated nasal septum. So students, there are two main operative procedures for deviated nasal septum. So firstly, we see medicinal treatment. What is the medicinal treatment? So we can try with medicines first, because as there is recurrent sinusitis, nose bleeding, but all this is because of the deviated structure of the septum of the nose, and we may try the medicines first. We may try decongestant drugs or antihistamines to decrease the symptoms of deviated nasal septum, but we may use antibiotics also, but these do not give long lasting result, and the complaints may recur further, because the maintaining cause of the infection is there, that is the deviated septum. So we have to go for permanent solution of this condition, and because for that we go for surgical procedures, and there are two important surgical procedures. First is SMR, that is septal mucosal resection. In this, the septum is the part of septum which is affected, it is removed from the from its side. So suppose it is a C-shaped deviation, so that part which is affected, it is removed, and rest of the part is again packed with the mucous membrane. But the drawback of this procedure is that the nose may become saddle nose. Okay, so after the removal of cartilage, there will be saddling of the nose, and this is the important complication of this procedure, and the person looks cosmetically very ugly. So nowadays this procedure is generally avoided, and the new procedure is septoplasty. So what we do in septoplasty is that the part which is affected, it is broken into pieces. The extra piece, small piece, is removed, and other pieces are joined together, and they are sutured again, or they are fixed in their position with the help of packing, and with the help of suturing the mucous membrane. So septoplasty is more advanced and more important than the other procedures. Now, what are the homeopathic medicines which you can use in cases of deviated nasal septum? Homeopathic medicines can give relief in cases of recurrent sinusitis, like Kali bichromicum, Bryonia. These medicines can be used. And if there is bleeding from the nose, at that time we can use medicines like Hamamelis or Millifolium or Ficus religiosa. So these medicines are important medicine in cases of deviated nasal septum. So that's it from the today's presentation. So thanks for watching. Thank you.